opinion, Butterfield is the finest blues harmonica player in the world.
Paul Butterfield was a legendary blues harmonica player from Chicago's South Side. The interracial Paul Butterfield Blues Band broke new ground in blues. It's a new documentary that chronicles Butterfield's life now called Horn from the Heart, the Paul Butterfield story. John Anderson directed the film, and he joins us now. Welcome. Nice to have you here with us.
Thank you. Good to be here, Dean.
What an idea, because this is such a quintessential sound of South Side blues in particular.
So overdue. You know, it's unbelievable the film hadn't been made. And, you know, Paul was a one-of-a-kind, hard-nosed kid. And it's truly a story of Chicago strength and individuality.
Now, if you know the music, I mean, that sort of speaks for itself. But what surprised you as you began digging into this?
Paul wasn't caught up in the trappings of fame, and that may have something to do with the fact that many people don't know of his songs. He never really had a big hit. He was all about the music and expressing himself, and when he found the harmonica, he taught himself how to play it and became a genius on it in 6 months. So it was all a matter of self-expression to him.
And when we say the harmonica, I mean, he was, when you listen to him, I think we're underselling it a little bit. I mean, he's on the Mount Rushmore. He has to be one of the greatest harmonica players to ever live. How good he was with that.
He does, and that's, I think, why everybody that we called to be in the film said, yes, where do I need to be?
Wow. So he's one of the few people that's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Blues Hall of Fame, right? That's a short list.
It is.
And so how did you become interested in doing this feature on him? What is it about him?
I saw him a couple of weeks before Woodstock, and he blew my mind at a big pop festival called the Atlantic City Pop Festival. And the guy was intense and so into the music, and he made a mark. And then some 45 years later, the executive producer, Sandy Warren, was looking to make this film, contacted Corky Siegel here in town, and he said that I ought to do it, having done a couple of other Chicago blues films in the last couple of years, Born in Chicago and Sam Lay in Bluesland.
Mm.
Do you think that the blues is undersold as a musical genre? I mean, you know, people like it and they go to the clubs, but it's always been amazing to me. There's never been a blues radio station in Chicago. I mean, there are blues fests, but, you know, for the most part, it's sort of like almost like a stepson to other musical genres.
It is, and it is remarkable, and especially when you consider that it's the root of just about any other type of music you can get to.
How groundbreaking was the band that he put together in the 60s in that turbulent time?
Well, not only was it groundbreaking in the sense that it added that hard rock edge to the Chicago blues and brought blues to the rock audience, but he was also a social justice pioneer. It was an interracial band. He had Sam Lay and Jerome Arnold, who he'd gotten from Howlin' Wolf's band, to be part of it. Never crossed his mind, never crossed anybody in the band's mind what color everybody was, but in that way he kind of set a tone too in a time where it wasn't that popular to believe in social justice.
Mm.
Did it ever get in the way of them having, you know, getting bookings places that it was a interracial band?
It did, and Paul told Billy Davenport, the black drummer in his band, where you can't go, we won't go. So they didn't go to the South much. You won't find many tour itineraries that include the South. He didn't want to be part of that scene.
As is the case with, you know, most of the greats, some of today's top performers credit legendary people like Paul Butterfield with, you know, their interest in music. Who did you find who was influenced by Paul Butterfield?
Well, back to that issue, it goes back to Hyde Park too, doesn't it? Because when he was growing up, it was one of the rare successfully interracial neighborhoods. So I think that is what he brought forward into the rest of his life. I'm sorry, Dean, your question though.
Well, my question was, who did he influence of today's artists that you must have talked to?
You know, John Popper, you look at, it's not just harmonica players, it's guitar players, it's John Mayer, you know, it's Gary Clark Jr. Anybody you ask is probably going to say, when it comes to the blues, who communicated to you the most directly, and Paul is right at the top of that list.
And we saw we're looking at clips from the documentary here. We saw Bonnie Raitt there a second ago, and like you said, all of these people, even though he might not be the household name like his mentor Muddy Waters, it's just everyone who's a musician knows this guy and how instrumental he was.
They do, and you know, it's not just blues guys, it's rockers, it's the Todd Rundgrens, it's
Brian Wilson there.
Brian Wilson, wow.
Wow.
Well, that's a different film. That's a
Brian. Oh, that's the other film you did with Brian Wilson.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
But the list is long, though.
It is.
I'm surprised there's not, you know, there's not a tribute to him on the South Side. you know, Paul Butterfield.
I think that's coming. Yeah. You know, yeah. I think that with the release of this film on DVD in around April, I think that we're going to line up some things like that.
Well, it's great to meet you, John. The documentary is called Horn from the Heart, the Paul Butterfield story. It'll be screening across the country beginning in January. For more information, head to hornfromtheheart.com. John, pleasure
to meet
you.
Thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks, John.